Hello guys, and welcome to Mouse Droplet Gaming. This is the next boss walkthrough, and this is at Anor Londo, and this is Aldrich, Devourer of the Gods. This boss is one of the trickier bosses I found during my game, and I would say that it's probably best to summon someone on this occasion. From my experience, I think that he is actually weak. His weakness is fire. But he is resistant to magic and poison slash toxic stuff, so it's best if you can to kind of maybe use lightning or fire to take him on. And if you can get someone to help you take him on and summon someone, it certainly makes things a lot easier. His attacks tend to be, they're not fast, but they're very powerful, especially the blasts he sends out. And then once you start striking here, you have to watch out for the pulse he sends on the ground, and you have to get away. You can see here I got injured that time. And the key is to keep moving, and he tends to move diagonally across the room, so he'll spawn in one corner, attack for a while, and these arrows are really powerful, you have to avoid those. And then once you've dealt enough damage, he will sort of warp into the ground, and then he tends to end up in the other opposite corner of the room. So, yep, if you see here, he'll then spawn at the other side. Oh, he's outside this time. And again, watch out for the powerful arrow attacks that he sends down. It's just a case of rolling as fast as you can without getting stuck like that. So it's a case of just keep chipping away at his health, making sure you're staying topped up on your Estus flasks. And if there's a second player with you helping you out, it's good to kind of maybe one of you distract him one way while the other one gets around the back and attacks. Those arrows are the most powerful of his attacks, so if you get caught in that, you're probably going to die. So as soon as you see him pull out the bow, just try and make a move for it. Again, once about halfway through, like all bosses, they then go into their second state. With this guy, he gets a fire blade, which makes him more aggressive. You can see there on the back of him he's got like a large tail like thing, so it's good to try and attack that because he can't reach you while you're hitting that. So again here, just chipping away, slowly taking down health. I believe actually in this playthrough, the guy I'm fighting with dies, I think. Well, there might have been another boss, but you'll see in a minute that the boss here gets very aggressive and starts moving a lot faster. So again, it's just a case of luring him out, making sure you get enough attacks in, and then watching him warp to the other side of the room and quickly moving over. The faster you move towards him as he warps, the less likely he'll be able to power up his really powerful attack. So yeah, it's a case of just rolling and trying to get to him as quick as you can. Usually once I've tried the boss fights a few times, I tend to be able to master it and then kind of be able to beat each boss sort of under a few minutes, but this one certainly took a lot longer, and I'd say if you're struggling with this boss, it's a case of just being patient, making sure you're chipping away at his health, but don't worry about being too aggressive and don't get greedy when it comes to trying to get his health down. Right, you can see down, we're right down to the final moments. This is key, and you've got to make sure that your health is full, so stay topped up with your Estus flasks, keep moving. And I know it's tempting that when you see their health bar right down low to try and get aggressive and get greedy and move in for lots of big hits, but make sure that you can keep chipping away like you're just at the beginning of the fight. So that's how you beat that boss, and I will see you again next time.